Welcome to the Mariposa Show. Hi, I'm James Gomez, your special guest host today. And today we turn the tables on none other than Mariposa as I have the opportunity to interview her. So stay tuned for the Mariposa Show.
Feeling like I'm breathing my last breath. Feeling like I'm walking my last steps. Look at all of these tears I've wept. Look at all the promises that I've kept. Put my heart into your hands. Here's my soul to keep. I let you in with all that I can. You're not hard to reach, and you've blessed me with the best gift that I've ever known. You give me purpose. Yeah, you've given me.
Martinez, how are you today?
I'm good.
You're good. Now, first of all, tell me a little bit about yourself.
I froze.
Okay, no, you're
okay. Wait, I froze.
Okay, well, we'll keep going. Just relax. Okay. First of all, tell me a little bit about yourself. I mean, where were you born, first of all?
Wait, I got nervous.
You're just talking to me.
Okay,
you're just talking to me. You're talking
okay,
to me. You're just
again.
Talking to me again.
Oh, let's try it.
We're just
okay.
talking. Okay.
Today
we're here with Maria Martinez, and we're going to learn a little bit about her life.
A little bit about Mariposa.
That's right, Mariposa. Well, first of all, tell me, how did you get the nickname Mariposa?
There we go. I think it's a way of me expressing freedom. Kind of like coming out of a cocoon because of my abusive relationship. I was stuck in like a box, like I had no freedom.
Uh-huh.
And once I started talking to people and I would express how I grew as a person, it's where my wings came out and I thought of myself, hey, what better name than Mariposa?
And you came up with that yourself?
I did, for freedom.
Okay, let's go way back to your childhood. First of all, where were you born?
I was born in Mexico, in a small little town, in a small little village.
And what was the little village and town called?
It's called Guerrero, and it's Los Alces Guerrero.
And
near Acapulco.
Now tell me a little bit about your childhood. What did you do as a child?
As a child, I was very active with our schools. I liked to volunteer and play. I liked to dance. I was in dance competitions. And I enjoyed life just like everybody else. I was free. I didn't know evil. And I just remember playing with dolls, with corn, actually. It wasn't even dolls.
Corn husk?
Yeah, I play with corn. I would literally do like the whole hair and stuff.
So where do you fall into? You have brothers and sisters. Tell me, who are your brothers and sisters?
I have a beautiful sister, and then I have a younger brother, and then my second brother, and then it's me, and then it's my older sister.
Okay. So you're somewhere right in the middle of that.
Right.
So you used to play with dolls and in Mexico, were those the best of the times, you thought?
I would say yes, because I was so innocent. So yes, it was the best time. It's like, you're so happy, you're a child. There's no worries.
So looking back at your childhood, what is your fondest memory as a child?
I would have to say seeing my mom come home from her long doctor visit. I was so happy to see her because she would always bring me a toy.
Okay.
And I missed her.
So your parents, who are your parents?
My parents, my mom is no longer with us. Her name is Adelia Sedardra. My beautiful father is in Anaheim. Has the most hardworking man I know that works so hard to provide for me.
Where did your parents meet?
They met in Chicago.
They met in Chicago?
Yes.
And they fell in love?
I don't know. I don't think they were in love. I think they thought they were in love.
Why do you say you don't think they were in love?
I think they were in love after that, after they got together. I think my mom was running away from an abusive father. So, okay. She thought by leaving with him, it was going to be.
So you're saying the love grew over a period of time.
Right, okay. Right.
And then from Chicago, how did they end up in Mexico?
Well, they thought that since my father had land over there and my mom wanted to be part of her siblings, she wanted to be closer to them, so they moved back to Mexico.
And for you, what was your favorite part of your childhood?
Like, I would say the part where I got to travel and I got to do like a lot of dancing competitions, as far as I can remember, because I was happy, I was doing something I enjoyed.
So you really liked school growing up?
I did. Uh-huh. I did.
What did you do with your brothers and sisters? Were there any activities you all did as a family?
Well, see, the thing is, my sister was born in Chicago before my parents decided to move back to Mexico. So me and my sister didn't really grow up together. So
how much older is she than you?
A year older.
Okay.
A year older. So right after my parents left to Mexico, I believe my mom got sick. And then my sister's eye vision was really bad, so my father decided to move to California to help my sister, so her family fell apart.
Yeah.
Went apart. Didn't fell apart, but went apart for.
What illness did your mom have?
Lupus.
Now, can you tell me, do you remember when you were told that she was sick, or how did you find out that she was sick?
I didn't find out she was sick. Well, I knew she was sick, because my grandma had to take care of us, because she had to go to a doctor's appointment in Mexico, and sometimes she would stay there. And we were too young to know, So I probably found out she was sick when we had to move over here.
And you had to move to California?
California.
And you moved to California so she could get treatment?
So she can get treatment, yeah.
And what were those days like when she was sick for you?
Hard. Hard because it was... My childhood was in the hospital most of the time. Like, I didn't have a normal childhood like everyone else did. I would go to school, and from school I would go straight to the hospital to be with her because I was so close to her.
This is very painful for you to see her suffer.
It was. Actually, even when she came home, it was very painful. I still remember this day when we would bring her home because she got better, right? But she still had to get treatment. So nurses would just come, and it was like she got shots left and right. And I just remember hiding underneath the bed because I was so scared. And till this day, it has affected me where I don't do well with needles. It just panics me, yeah.
So about how long did this sick, when did you first basically find out that she was ill?
I must have been like 8, 9 years old when I found out.
So it was a long illness then, for a long time.
It was. Actually, according to what I was told from family members, they only gave her a year to live, and she lived a lot longer than what she was supposed to.
What did your mom mean to you?
The world. Till this day, she means the world to me. She shared a lot of beautiful moments, and she taught me a lot of good values.
What's the best lesson she ever taught you?
To love and forgive. And to never wish bad upon anybody, as much as they hurt you.
If your mom were here today, what do you think she'd think of you today?
I think she'd be like crazy in love with her grandkids. And I'm not just talking about mine, I'm talking about my sisters and brothers in general. And I think she would be very proud of my accomplishments. And I like to think she'd be very proud of me. I was her princess. I was her everything. And to this day, I think I can feel her present, and we're still close. Yeah.
You pray to her, or
I talk to her. Yes.
What do you tell her?
I told her English got better over time. Yes. I feel like sometimes I'm getting ready to go to work or to go to an event or to help in any way I can, in a cause or a charity, and I'm trying to like look good because I'm always worried about what I'm wearing and how I'm wearing it and not repeating it and like matching stuff. And sometimes I feel like she'll like throw something at me and be like, and throw this on. And I'm like, oh, like this will match you. This will look good. And I'm like, oh, mom, your English has gotten so much better over time.
Now let's talk a little bit about when you lost your mom. I mean, at what point did you realize that she wasn't going to get better and it was headed down a path that you really didn't want to go to?
I always prayed, because I was raised Catholic. I always prayed to Virgin Mary when she got sick, when they had to rush her to the hospital, which was pretty scary. And because she had to be rushed to the hospital like many times, many, many times. Her illness, and I always prayed to Virgin Mary, and I never thought, I actually thought she was forever.
You thought she was going forever?
I thought she was forever. I never thought, I don't even think I knew what death was at that time.
So, where did she pass away? Where were you? How did you find out?
I was actually home. It was December 25th, a day right.
Christmas Day.
After Nochebuena, we had family over from Chicago. It was beautiful. She was happy. I was home. My sister was home. We were all home in a small little apartment. We were all family crowded together.
Here in the park?
Yeah, it actually was very beautiful. She was happy. She had...
Whole family was together then?
She had two brothers of her visiting. And she had her nephews over. She was just happy. It happened so quick. It happened really, really quick. I still remember that. I heard my dad screaming, call 911. And I panicked. I just ran. Instead of calling 911, I just ran outside screaming for help. I just panicked.
Uh-huh. Was that the hardest part of your life, losing your mom?
Yes.
Were you able to tell her any final words?
I was too scared. I remember my sister hugging her. And crying and screaming, and I was scared. I was so scared, and that's it. I blacked out. I passed out. I was pregnant at that time. I was 4 months pregnant, and I blacked out. I don't remember anything. I just remember getting to the hospital, and some priest, no black, touching me from the back and telling me your mom has passed away, not knowing that I was pregnant, and I blacked out again. And they took me to a room, and I was in denial. I thought she was forever. I was in denial. It took me a long time to accept it.